Sonder in French, my mother tongue, means to explore in various ways and discover what is hidden, which I think is fantastic in the context of travel and kind of an appreciation of culture. I'm Francis Davidson, the co-founder and CEO of Sonder. What would be the ideal hotel room? And if I could tell you that it was a space that was extraordinarily well-designed, that was in any neighborhood you want, and that it's three times the size of a typical hotel room at, you know, 20% cheaper of the price. Basically, that's what Sonder is. I'm an entrepreneur by accident, I would say. Sonder was officially incorporated when I was a freshman in college. I was leaving for the summer, wanted to find a subtenant for my apartment. With my co-founder, Lucas, we convinced a bunch of really entrepreneurial students to do it in a bunch of other cities. We didn't have any money to hire them, so we basically just said, hey, we're gonna tell you how to do this, we're gonna take a cut of the profits. And what's crazy is that it actually worked. Like, we made $1 million in sales that summer, as that's when I officially, you know, kind of stopped attending university. We saw, hey, it will be inevitable that, you know, in the same way that hotels started with independent hotels, we thought that a similar shift would occur in alternative accommodations, and we set out to build that brand. On the one hand, we want the Sonder experience to be highly consistent. We want the service to be rapid and friendly. We want the spaces to be high quality, to be comfortable and safe. But at the same time, we don't want the experience to be cookie cutter. The mistake I think the hospitality industry has done in the last, you know, few decades is to standardize it to such a degree that there is very little diversity or surprise left. And basically, if you think, like, what is the reason why people travel? They want it to be different. They want, you know, the culture of a city, of a country, to like shine through their experience from beginning to end. One core tenet of our business is to actually embrace this diversity. And that's what makes travel exciting. So we've selected and partnered with developers and leased properties that we fully control, studios, multi-bedroom spaces, and recently as well, small hotels. You know, we have a model whereby we operate the properties ourselves and manage to do that while still making the experience affordable, introducing technology at every layer of the operation. You know, one thing that's a little bit crazy when you go in a hotel today is to notice how little technology is being utilized. If you unpacked the $250 that you paid for a hotel every night, there would be a very small amount that would be for the actual space. So what we've done is basically rethink, what do people actually value? We can deliver a series of these services mostly through technology, and so you can meet high standards for the experience in small properties. 12 months ago, we had 2,200 units, and now we have 9,000. We're in 28 cities, 1,000 employees, I think 6 or 7 countries, and we're opening nearly a country a month at this point. And it would be great to do this literally all over the world. I think it's not just because we're an ambitious business, but because there's a fundamental need. If we gain the trust of guests and customers in one city, then we're gonna wanna be there wherever else they go.